Hi, I'm Barry Bubolz with the Natural Resources Conservation Service, Area GLRI Coordinator, working with the demonstration farms up in Northeast Wisconsin. And so today we're out here in a field and we want to discuss and talk about how manure applications and cover crops can work together. The timing of the manure application is very important. So when we have these cover crops established, we want to wait for those cover crops to be a couple inches tall before we come back in with that manure application. That established plant then is going to have a lot better chance of recovering from the disturbance of the manure being injected into the ground. When selecting the species of cover crops, the best species to select are those that are going to be able to grow into the fall the longest and be able to recover from the manure application. So when we look at winter cereals, such as winter cereal rye, winter triticale, and winter wheat, those are probably the three best species for this system in Wisconsin. They're just going to give us the longest growth and the best rooting densities going into the winter. Another factor to take in consideration with manure and the timing of cover crops is maybe backing off on that maturity date of your corn. So instead of that harvest of silage occurring in late September, early October, maybe pushing that forward into the middle of September. So just giving yourself a couple extra days, couple extra weeks, and allow that cover crop to be planted and get established. Since we're recommending the cover crop to be established first, we need to make sure that the manure can be applied to these fields in a method that does not destroy the cover crops. And so several options exist for accomplishing that. One being a low disturbance injection, and the other being a surface application to those cover crops. There's several different low disturbance toolbars that are out there on the market, and it's very important that you evaluate and choose the toolbar that works the best for your farm and your soils while maintaining the goal of keeping your cover crop growing into the winter. For producers that choose to utilize a surface application of manure, evaluating the infiltration of the soil is key. And so fields that have poorer infiltration, the rates are going to need to be reduced. And for those fields that are in good shape with covers and a higher infiltration rate, we may be able to utilize a rate up of 7,500 to 10,000 gallons. When applying manure that has higher solids content, it's also very important that we adjust the rate on that so that we're not smothering the cover crop. And distribution coming from the spreader is also a key factor to consider. This is an example of an excellent cover crop that had a low disturbance manure application a couple weeks ago. This winter rye is growing very well and is going to continue to thrive going into this fall and winter. It's offering excellent protection to the soil surface and retention of nutrients. Next spring, this winter rye is going to continue to grow, and this field will be an excellent candidate for no-till planting. In summary, manure can be applied to a cover crop. It's just important that we keep in mind the application rate, the timing, the method, and the species that we plant.